Thanks, everyone. Excited to be here today. I'm excited to tell you about how we're planning to change the lives of people with chronic stroke with the first ever treatment for chronic disability from stroke. There are about 7.5 million people who are living today in this country with chronic disability as a result of stroke, and another 400,000 people added to that each year. If you don't mind helping play the video, please. That was Heather, and you can see, yeah, there we go. You can see here the effect of chronic stroke for her. She's trying to do this task where she's feeding herself. She can't hold the fork very tightly with her hand. She doesn't have full range of motion either in her elbow or in her wrist, as you'll see here. And ultimately, this means she can't do this task. She has to use her other hand to assist. This is representative of a huge population in the US. So how can we help Heather? We're using electrical stimulation of the spinal cord to directly restore a person's ability to control their own movements. What happens when a stroke damages the connection between the brain and the spine and ends up leaving someone permanently disabled is that the signals are now effectively weakened because of this damage. We can stimulate the sensory neurons in part of the spinal cord below the lesion of the stroke and actually use that to help the signals from the brain that have been weakened from the stroke make their way all the way to the muscles. In the end, the result is that that person is able to completely volitionally control their own movement as if they were controlling it naturally from before the stroke. We do this using spinal cord stimulation. It's implanted in the epidural space of the cervical spinal cord. And you can see that in the animation on the right. The market size is there. Like I said before, there are 7.5 million people who are living with chronic deficit from stroke. We've already done the work to segment the chronic stroke market and figure out who would be the best responders for this therapy from our initial clinical results. That represents 140,000 patients per year in the US, and that's about 3 times the size of the largest neuromodulation market today, which is chronic pain. Our next steps are to run a chronic clinical study with 20 patients. We'll be doing that at the end of this year. And we're currently also doing some product development work to be able to automate the process of how we deliver stimulation and how we optimize it for each and every patient. Uniquely here, every patient has a heterogeneous set of needs, and we need to program stimulation so that they get the most benefit for themselves. Now I'd like to show you what this device is capable of. On the left is the same video I showed you before, now on the right with our stimulation turned on. For her, this is the difference between being able to feed herself and not. I do want to highlight that the blinking lights on her arm are not there just because of it's not near Christmas or anything. But because we're using them to record muscle activity during the study, they would not be part of the final product, which would be a fully implantable device. You wouldn't know that somebody has it. So I'd like to end by bragging a bit about our team. We have clinicians, neurosurgeons, industry experts, academic KOLs, all part of our team, and I'm very fortunate to be a part of it as well. So with that, I'll thank you. You can reach us at this email address. Please feel free to reach out. We're raising a $5 million seed round, looking to fill the round with $1.5 more million. Thank you.